joining us now to answer your tax questions is Pam King Smith of King King and Associates. Good morning. Thanks for being here, Pam. We've got quite a few emails coming in. Okay. Obviously, we're right at tax time, and folks are getting a little bit antsy. We'll start with this one. I have a student loan that I will be paying for the next 8 years. What are the terms for being able to deduct the interest from the student loan on a married tax form, and is there a stipulated period of time that I can claim the student loan interest?
Okay. Well, as with many of the IRS rules, there are exceptions, but here's the general rule is you can deduct up to $2,500 in student loan interest based on your income. For single taxpayers, it's up to about $60,000. After that, if it starts to phase out. Mm-hmm. For married filing jointly, if your income is up to $120,000, you can take it, and then it starts to phase out. And it's for a period of about 5 years.
Okay. So. All right, next question is, my husband forgot to file his taxes in 2005. How do I go about finding his W-2 for that year? We cannot find the original.
Well, one, you can try to go back to the employer if he still knows the employer, if the company is still in business. Mm-hmm. Or you can actually request what they call a transcript from the IRS. The IRS would have a copy of any of the W-2s and stuff that you have earned, so the IRS may be an option if the employer is not reachable.
Okay, so you just have to do a little legwork
there. Yes, it'll take a little while, especially for the 2005 year.
Yeah, 2005. All right, my husband and I bought our house within the time parameters for the first-time home buyer's $8,000 tax credit and have all documentation for it. We purchased the property at full market value from my husband's deceased brother's estate, but now we've been told that we cannot take advantage of the credit because my husband was related to the deceased. Is this true?
Right. Unfortunately, there are regs. In the regs, it says that the credit is not deductible if you buy the house from a related party. So they may be saying that the estate is in a related party because it's related to the husband's brother.
Okay.
So you cannot take the credit if you purchase that home from a related party, family member, things like that.
Okay. My wife and I have filed jointly since 1995. Recently, she received an IRS notice that she failed to file for 2009. How can that be?
The only thing I can think of right now is maybe her Social Security and name is not matching, maybe from the marriage, and even though they've been filing jointly for the past 15 years, I would just contact them to say that we filed a joint return and have them match the name and the Social Security number. Sometimes when the females get married and if they don't change the last name, the mm-hmm. IRS is still looking for her maiden name matched up with the Social Security. And if she's filing a joint return, they see it under the husband's last name.
Okay.
So that may be the issue.
You have to go
there.
Back and iron out those details.
Right.
What documentation must be sent to the IRS to claim an adoption credit?
Okay, the adoption credit. Well, first of all, you have to file a paper return, so you cannot e-file for if you're claiming the adoption credit. But things such as the final adoption decree has to be attached to the return. Any paperwork maybe from the courts saying that the adoption went through, paperwork from the agency that placed the child. So those are the kinds of things, the documentation that's needed to be attached to the return.
Okay, so get those documents. As one of three siblings, I received $41,000 as my share of the proceeds of my deceased parents' home. How do I report this on my taxes?
Normally, that would come through the estate. The estate would have to have sold the house, so the distribution from the estate is not taxable to the beneficiaries. There may be some estate tax return taxes due, but the beneficiaries do not have to report any distribution from an estate return.
Okay.
As a general rule.
All right. And here's the last question. In processing my 2010 tax return using TurboTax, I was displayed a message that I can invest in a $5,000 for single or $6,000 for married filed jointly in a 2010 IRA or Roth IRA and deduct this investment on my 2010 return. Is this true? And if it is, which is a better, Roth IRA or just an IRA?
Well, the two different IRAs that you're talking about, the traditional IRA, that's deductible, so you can get the deduction on the return. The Roth IRA is not a deduction on your return, so it depends on whether they're looking to maybe reduce their income now with that traditional or wait till later when they withdraw the money from a Roth IRA, it's not included in your income.
Okay.
So it kind of is going to depend on whether they're trying to reduce their income now or wait till later. There are two different types of IRAs, that traditional and the Roth. One is deductible and one is not.
Okay. It gets really complicated, doesn't
yes,
it?
Yes, it does.
Thank you for helping us iron out everything, and we appreciate you being here. If you didn't get your question answered this morning, we will answer it next week, so keep them coming. You can email tax questions directly to taxquestions@WBALTV.com or go to our website, WBALTV.com, and click on Consumer Alert.